the data is organized in memory is stored by something called a symbol table, which contains the information about all our symbolic identifiers. So the compiler basically knows for a particular function, it keeps this kind of records for a name, which is the identifier of a variable. It stores which type this variable is, and then it stores the address in memory. So at runtime from the compiler, it basically creates this table for the identifiers as they are defined in the source code, and then assigns them to these memory addresses, which are then, like we said, our stack frames. That's all the purpose of the compiler. Note there is also there is yet another symbol table, you could say. We'll talk about this a bit later, but this is during the compilation stage this process happens, and at runtime we don't know anymore which variable is which. We don't know the name anymore. We only will directly access it using these memory locations. Okay, so that's why it's really hard when you have a compiled code without debugging flags set. You don't know anything about the names, so it's difficult to infer what the code was doing. Okay, and we will only see basically those kind of assembler instructions, and then we have to guess that whatever was at location minus 12 might have been an integer variable and stuff like this. Okay, so that's what the symbol value does. Now let's have a look into the a principle called call by value, which describes how you communicate information between the functions. And there are generally two ways of calling a function: call by value, which we learned today, and call by reference, which we learn in our pointer lecture, which is in another week. So what does call by value mean? Well, you have to copy the argument passed to the function. Like in our example, when I have a local variable, here, like an argument is actually nothing more than a local variable, then when I call this function, I have to copy the actual value into the memory cell on the function activation record. Okay? It also means whenever I inside this function, func here, whenever I change x, I only change this copy inside the memory of on the stack of this activation record. The good thing about it that it isolates the function caller from the called function. So if I accidentally change here a variable, I can never propagate this information back to another function, like here the main function, because the x here is a different x than any other variable on the main. So here is an example. To get through this, we see a function that returns a double value, and it computes the distance to a midpoint based on two positions, x and y. So it's a 2D kind of function that returns then here the Euclidean distance to the midpoint, which is at location 0, 0. Okay, so that's all what it does. So now let's have a look how to use such a function. Well, let's say we want to call distance to midpoint function with x and y from main. At this location here, when we try to process this code with our instruction pointer, we would not know anything about the values of x, y, and result. But on our main activation record, we know the compiler has created three memory locations, one for x, one for y, and one for result, to store the data. But the values are initialized. After we've processed x equals 3 and y equals 4, well, the memory cells have been assigned with the appropriate values. Result is still uninitialized because we assigned it over here. Now we finally call from this line the distance to midpoint function. At this location, we create two local variables, x and y, it's called again, and a new distance variable. And now immediately after this function has been called, we copy these values, x and y, from here, from the call, which have been the parameters. We have to copy the actual values into them. And what are the actual values? Well, the actual values at this line of code have been 3 and 4. So we copied them into these new variables x and y. And note, these are really new variables. They have a new location in main memory, and they differ from those here, albeit they have the same name. But this is just a symbolic name, right? So now we perform here some operations by here dividing x with 2. Well, the result is only reflected in the stack activation frame for this function over here. Well, we compute another result, and then we compute distance. And finally, here we call the return distance. Here the distance was 2.5, right? So we want to return this number. What will happen when this function has returned? It basically knows that the value here and the return value has been 2.5, and this value gets then assigned to result. So after the instruction pointer has completed this line here, we have assigned result a value 2.5. So